Hello students, today we'll start with the modern periodic table. So what does the modern periodic law say? It says that the physical and chemical properties of the elements are a periodic functions of their atomic numbers. As you can see, hydrogen atomic number 1, lithium 2, beryllium 3, boron 4 and so on. Now, since the elements are arranged in the increasing order of the atomic number, elements which are in the same group will have same number of valence electrons. For example, hydrogen, lithium, sodium, they'll have one valence electron. Beryllium, magnesium, calcium, they'll have two valence electrons and so on. Okay, and because of that, they will show periodicity. That is, chemical properties will also show periodicity. Why? Periodicity means reoccurrence of similar properties after a certain interval of time. Now, chemical properties are dependent upon the number of valence electrons. Okay, for example, we take the first group. In this group, all are metals except hydrogen. There is a controversy regarding the position of hydrogen since it shows the property of both alkali metals as well as it shows similarity with group 7 halogens. But since it is based, the modern periodic table is based on increasing number of atomic number, it is given the first position though it is a non-metal. Okay, so if we take the elements lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium, they are all alkali metals. They all are good reducing agents. Why? Because they can easily lose their one electron and form positively charged iron. They are soft metals. They are very reactive. That's why they are mainly found in the combined state in the nature. Okay. So, what is the cause of periodicity? It is the same number of electrons in the outermost shell, or we can say reoccurrence of similar electronic configuration. Okay. So, you have to learn this. What is periodicity of elements? No, properties that reappear at regular intervals, or which in which there is a gradual variation. Variation means either there is an increase or decrease, are called periodic properties, and the phenomenon is known as periodicity of elements. Okay, in a particular group, since the number of electrons in the outermost shell, it remains the same. That's why valence remains the same, and hence the chemical properties also remains the same. Now, according to the recommendation of IUPAC, okay, the groups are numbered from 1 to 18, replacing the older notations of groups 1A to group 0. As you can see here, no, 1A, 2A, then how the groups were arranged? After that, 3B, 4B, 5B, 6B, 7B, then group 8, which has 3 subgroups, then 1B, 2B, then again 3A, 4A, 5A, 6A, 7A and group 0. So, according to the new notation, they are numbered as 1 to 18, okay? As you can see here, 1 to 18, this is the latest notification, okay? Now, you see how many elements are there in the first period? 2, which is known as the shortest period. Second period, 8, so it is known as the short period. Third period, 3, short period, okay? Fourth period, long period, 18 elements. Fifth period, long period, 18 elements. Sixth period, longest period because it has 32 elements. Seventh period, longest period because it has 32 elements. Now here you can see the subgroups also in Roman notation as well as the latest notation, IUPAC notation. Both are given. Okay, 1, 1A, 2, 2A. Okay, group 18 or it is also known as group 0 group. Okay. Now, what are the features of the modern periodic table? Now, you all know the vertical columns are called as groups and the horizontal rows are called as the periods. Okay. So, it has 18 vertical columns. You know that very well. Elements of subgroup A, that is 1A to 7A, or if we take IUPAC notation 1, 2, 13 to 17, they are known as main group elements or representative elements or the normal elements. Why? Because they have their outermost cells incomplete. Then elements of group 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 and 12. They are known as transition elements because they have two outermost cells incomplete. So these are the transition elements 3 to 12. And which are the normal elements? These are the normal elements. Okay. Group 1A to group 7A. They are called as the representative elements. Okay. Then elements in the group 0 or the group 18. Okay. This group. They are known as the noble gases because they have stable electronic configuration. All of them have 8 electrons in their outermost cell except helium, which has 2 electrons. Now let us come to periods. How many horizontal rows are there? They are 7 rows. Okay, so all these are already discussed. How many elements are there? Now in group 3b of the 6th period, there is a set of elements with atomic number 57 to 71 beginning with lanthanum. So they are known as lanthanides or the rare earths. So you can see in which group? 3B or group 3 of the 6th period. So let us come to the 6th period. So this is group 3B of the 6th period. So here actually there is a set of elements. Starting from atomic number of lanthanum, that is 57 to 71. Okay, so they are placed at the bottom of the group, and this series is known as the lanthanide series or the rare earths. Okay, then in group 3B of the 7th period, there is a set of elements beginning with atomic number of actinium. Okay, you can see here beginning with actinium. So these elements are known as actinide series or radioactive elements. So you can see they are placed at the bottom of the periodic table. Why? If they are placed here, it will distort the shape and size of the modern periodic table. Okay, so lanthanides and actinides have similar properties. Why? Because they belong to the same group, 3B. But they are shown at the bottom of the periodic table because they are large in number, and showing them in the main body will distort the shape of the periodic table. Now let us come to types of elements. There are 4 types. The representative elements. Now a quick revision. What are representative elements? The elements belonging to group 1A to 7A, or according to IUPAC nomenclature, which are the representative elements? Group numbers 1, 2, 13, 14, 15, 16 and 17. Transition elements belonging to group 3 to 12. Inner transition elements. They are the actinide and the lanthanide series, and then the inert gases are noble gases. Okay. So these are the representative elements. Alkali metals, alkaline earth metals, boron, carbon family, nitrogen, oxygen, halogens, etc. Now, the alkali metals are the most reactive metals. Why? Because they have only one valence electron, which they easily lose. They react vigorously with water to produce hydrogen and an alkali solutions. And halogens are the most reactive non-metals. Why? Because they need to gain only one electron in order to be stable. Now, what are the main characteristics of representative elements? They include both metals and non-metals. There is a regular gradation from metallic to non-metallic as we move from left to right of the periodic table. You see, there is a gradation. These are metallic, and then you can see here, no? Here it's clearly given. Alkali metal, you can see here. These are the alkali metals. Then comes alkaline earth metals. Then you can see lanthanide, actinide. Okay. Then comes transition metal from group 3 to 12. Then comes this one. metalloids, no, which show the properties of both metals and non-metals. You can see a boron, silicon, germanium, etc. Then other non-metals are here, and these are the noble gases. Okay, so they form electrovalent as well as covalent compounds with non-metals, who the representative elements. If they are metallic, they'll form electrovalent bond. If they are non-metals, they will form covalent bonds. Metallic nature increases as you move down. Okay, metals which are good conductors are present in group 1 and 2, and non-metals which are present in group 16 and 17 are poor conductors of heat and electricity. And some heavier elements like tin and lead exhibit variable valency. Now let's move to transition elements. They have high melting and boiling point. They are good conductors of heat and electricity. They are attracted towards a magnet. That's why they are used as catalyst. They exhibit variable valency. They form colored ions and compounds. What about the lanthanides and the actinide series? They are known as the inner transition elements. They are heavy metals with high melting and boiling points. They show variable valencies. They form colored ions. Okay, and actinides are radioactive elements. What do you mean by that? They give out harmful radioactive rays. Then the inert gases are noble gases. Okay, so why are they stable? Because they have 8 electrons in the outermost shell. Now let's come to the Bries elements. The elements belonging to the second group, the elements belonging to the second period of the periodic table shows resemblance in properties of to the elements of the next group of the third period. As you can see here, lithium, which belongs to the second period, so resemblance in properties with magnesium, which belongs to the next group. So what is the next group to group 1? It is group 2 of the third period. Okay, so they form a diagonal relationship. So they are known as Bries elements. Example, lithium, magnesium, beryllium, aluminium, boron and silicon. Okay, so this is the definition of Bries elements. Then typical elements, the third period elements, sodium, magnesium, aluminium, silicon, phosphorus, sulfur and chlorine. Since they summarize the properties of the respective groups, that is summarize means most of them, they show most of the properties of the respective groups. That is why they are called as the typical elements. Thank you.